Hello, hello, what's up, y'all? Hi, this is your boy, Amson the Real. Well, I pray and hope that this video reaches y'all in the best of health and in the best of spirit. So today in this particular video, I decided to go around to speak with my fellow Africans, ask them questions regarding their journey from Africa to Europe, their experiences, you understand, here in Europe, both the good and the bad, of course, you understand. And also, of course, I asked them questions to answer regarding their expectations of Europe when they live in Africa, how they thought of Europe before actually coming down here and get confronted with the reality of this land here, you understand, called Europe. So they had some kind of interesting answers to my questions. They gave some very interesting answers to my questions. Answers which you're going to discover in the video or moments from now on. You see, the video was actually very long, so I decided to divide the video into three parts. So this particular part is the part one. In this part one, I spoke with a West African guy by the name of Malik. I asked Malik different questions. Let's do this. So find out all my interesting questions to Mr. Malik, and as well as to find out Malik's interesting answers to my questions, you gotta be willing to watch this video until the end. So all my YouTube subscribers, thank you so much for hanging around. And to all my viewers, always remember to subscribe, activate the notification button so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. Until next time, see y'all again. Boom. Hello, hello. What's up, bro? How are you doing, man?
I'm cool, bro.
How's life?
Good, nice to meet you.
My name is Omar. And you?
Nice to meet you, Malik.
Yeah, nice to meet you, man.
Where are you from, Omar?
I'm actually from Mali. I'm originally from Mali in Western Africa. I don't know if you know about that country. And you, where are you from?
Yeah, of course, I'm some part of West Africa.
Okay, you're a Western African.
Yeah.
Okay, you don't need to tell me the name of your country, of course. So you live here in Germany?
Yeah, I've been here in Germany for a couple of 5 years now.
Okay, you live in Germany. You have been living in Germany now for like 5 years. Okay, so how's life here in Germany? What is the living condition? How's life?
Well, the life is everywhere. It's the same to worldwide. There's nowhere to be, nowhere that is easy. You know, when you find yourself in a strange place, which is not your life, you don't have to go do your things according to the law, go straight, do the right thing so that you can keep yourself from any other trouble against the law of the country.
Yeah, that's true. You mean if you wanted to live in Germany here, you have to just, you know, be like a straightforward person. You have to respect the rules and the regulations and the law of the country.
You get my point. Yeah. Most people are abiding citizens. Even if you are not yet a citizen, at least, you know, they say when you are in Rome, you do what the Romans do to live.
Exactly.
So when you are in such a country which is not your country, you have to abide with the law, normal to the normal procedure.
Exactly.
To achieve your goal and aim.
Exactly. And before coming to Europe here, you said you have been living in the whole of Europe. You have been living for 5 years, or only in Germany for 5 years?
I've been some part of a European country before I've been here in Deutschland. And I experienced some other life over there before I came down here.
Exactly. Yeah.
And the life is little built, different.
Yeah.
You know, some of the European countries they have different system, different government, different procedure for the migrant.
Yeah.
In Germany, they still have their own system because it's different, even though they are one European country.
You mean you was living in a different European country before coming to Germany?
Of course.
But that country's system or way of life is a little bit different from that of Germany.
Yeah,
they have their way of life, and Germany has its own way of life also.
Yeah, bro. That's right. That's getting the point.
Exactly.
Some part of Europe, normally you live your life, which is, you are a stranger in the land.
Before
you can be able to meet up with your demand or your focus or what you're concentrating to do,
you have
to pass through along so many rules and regulations, and you have to abide with the law
so
that you can be able to achieve your aim.
So that you can be able to integrate in the society,
accept
it in the society, and find your way.
Yeah, that is it.
Exactly, I understand. So what do you do here in Germany? You work here? Or?
Actually, I've been working here in the biggest city in Germany. Okay.
Right, Munich.
Munich.
Yeah, we are in Munich. Let me remind my viewers that we are in Munich.
Munich. This Munich is one of the biggest city in Germany.
In Germany, and the richest and the richest city in Germany.
And they are very strong, hardworking people.
Yeah.
And if you can go to some part of the Germany, find out the system is not almost the same. But here, you get upper hand.
They
give you the opportunity to work to any living.
You
can meet up with your dream.
You can meet up with your dream. You can make your dreams come true.
That is it.
That's very good, man. Okay, so what do you think of these people of Munich? Since you don't know Germans generally, what has been your experience here in Munich with the people? What do you think of the people of this particular city? How are they welcoming of foreigners, and in particular, are they welcoming of Africans?
Yeah, actually, it's everywhere, not only in Munich. When you go to a stranger house, before you can be able to give it trust to embrace you, you know, it can take time. Because it's not nowadays, you don't really have to trust anybody, especially we that came from the other part of the world. Sometimes they call it we came from a third world country. You understand? So we have to do things right. You know, to gain the trust from them.
So we can that's be able very important. No, that's very true.
Do things right. Participate in the society, work. Understand? Not just sitting your ass doing nothing. That doesn't help. If they are living the way they think we are living, I don't think we're going to be here.
They would never be developing like this.
Thank you. Wake up, strong, puzzle, do things right, build our nation. So we just came here, even though we need help. At least let us add to the society, not take from the society, so that I can get a contribution.
That's true. That's very true. I agree with you 100%.
In terms of migrant, it's general. You know, we experience some one or two issues in terms of races, but not all. There's some few who doesn't travel out of their country or have not been to somewhere.
Some of them who are not open-minded.
They are not open-minded people. That's how it is. But with little patience and dedication, you can be able to
make it
gain the trust
in one way or another.
You can welcome to the society fully. But it's not easy, bro, to be in a foreign land, especially where black man.
It's not easy. You mean it's not easy? You mean there is still some kind of hostility toward black people in particular in this country, or not in this country in general, but in this city. And like you say, it's not all people, but some.
You know, the picture they see in social media, and
in their news,
and in some other,
it's always
media
negative things.
World, they always have this negative thought towards we, the foreigners. But you know, there's one thing they have to remember, that we are not equal.
It's true.
Exactly, because when you give someone go ahead, okay, come to my house, first monitor that person, how did he behave, how did he act to the society, he's doing this right. That is how he's supposed to do. You can't just categorize everybody that because he came from social country, or because he's also person by nature, he categorized it. That is not how it is. So
that
we need help. That is why we're here.
That
you
is
understand,
true.
Bro?
That is true, That's very true, man. Okay, now we have spoken about the attitudes of the people. You have told me about the country you come from. Not the country, but the side of Africa where you come from. You understand? And also, we spoke about your journey within Europe. You said you have been in one European, another European country before coming to Germany. You understand? So what did you think of Europe? How did you see Europe? You understand? Before coming to Europe, how did you think of Europe?
Absolutely.
And after coming to Europe, how did you find Europe? Did you find it the way you was thinking of it back in Africa? Or there is a difference?
Actually, you know, in this life, there's no place like home.
Yeah,
I don't mean to left my home out of my will.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, a problem took me out of my country, and I believe this is the right place because they have categories of human rights activists. They have humanitarian issue.
Right,
they can be able to give us the assisting hand. Not all of us.
Yeah,
I know.
Yeah.
Not everybody they can welcome to their house, but at least those that dedicate and concentrate to do something tangible with their life, positive meaning things.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
Here in Europe,
yeah,
the way we see things back at home, this is not how it is.
Yeah.
You understand?
Uh-huh.
Actually, it's like, let me not say in the front of video maybe, but it's like a trap, you know.
So you mean it's like a trap?
Yeah.
You mean when you are, for example, in Africa,
yeah,
how you hear of Europe or how you see Europe in the news, yeah, when you come to Europe, you see it as a trap, you understand? You feel like it is completely different.
It's completely different. Why? Because the way we taught the other is not how they are, is they are very hardworking people.
Yeah, yeah.
That is why we back at home, we like see everywhere develop, like everywhere good road, good facility.
Yeah.
We envy them. But we don't know what they pass through.
It's true.
And that is what we forget back at home. Why we have almost 80% of the resources to develop our land before we have bad government, bad leaders.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, that is what is really making life more complicated for we that came from other parts of the world.
Yeah.
That is a bit what I find that not really all European countries, but here in the city, the Greater Munich, we call it Greater Munich.
Yeah.
Because there's no any other city like Munich for the whole Germany.
There is no city like Munich.
No,
man. This is Munich.
It's Greater Munich.
Yeah.
If you want to be a man, you wake your ass like a man and do things right.
And you will find your way.
Find your way out.
Okay.
That is it.
Okay, now one thing I would like to ask you right now is what is a message you would tell the young African man who is in Africa, who dreams of making it to Europe one day, who dreams of coming to Europe one day, what would you tell that person?
Well, actually, to travel, to experience some part of culture traditionally
in
some other continent of the world is another development, like it's another knowledge,
which
you can pick one of two things, you can learn one of two things.
Yeah.
But the way they thought it is, maybe it's easy when you've been here, you find life very easy, you can fly in the jet, you can fly in the Ferrari, in the Lamborghini. Let them not think that.
These
people are very hard-working people.
They
work towards it to achieve all those things.
Yeah.
So please, my people back at home, my brother, sister, all those that thinking maybe they want to come here for greener pasture, brother, with us trying to be a man in that country, let us develop our land to just like the way the European did that.
It's true, it's true.
That is the advice, my fellow brother.
Okay, thank you very much,
bro. Thank you so much, bro.
I don't remember your name again.
Malik.
You said your name. Your name is Malik. Okay, nice to meet you, Malik.
Nice,
and it was very good chatting with you,
thank
Malik.
Thank you. Thank you.
So we have come to the end of this interview now with Mr. Malik. I have asked him questions, which you are going to see now in the video on YouTube. You understand? So we have come to the end. Take care of yourselves, guys.